experience or history teaches us that all those who fought against FIFA, the internal, you know, the wranglings internally, all those who went to CAS, even though they had one or two cases upturned, it didn't end well for them.
Well,
being a man, case in point.
Precedence doesn't favor Platini at all. But Platini is I think I'm actually, you know, constrained to say that Platini is not like any other person who has contested, because he's supremely powerful.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
He's supremely influential.
Influential.
He has a lot of goodwill, and to be honest, a lot of people in UEFA and other federations
are still loyal to him.
Are still loyal to him, and would love nothing better than to see him being cleared of any charges and you know, be given the opportunity to contest the presidency.
Mm.
If he does, he's definitely without a shade of doubt the strongest candidate. And like I said before, FIFA presidency in waiting. So, you know, it's still dicey as everything is right now. There's so much that can still go on, so much that can go right, so much that can go wrong.
Okay.
But right now, I think he's loading all the bullets into his gun and just firing off in every direction and hoping he hits something.
But he has a limited time.
Yeah,
as I said earlier, this is December. He's facing the ethics committee on the 16th.
Yeah.
Election is in February, so anything he wants to do right now, he has less than 2 months.
But you see, he's been told that, look, if you clear your name, we'll reassess you.
That's what we're saying.
And that's comforting.
Yes.
That's comforting to know that if he clears his name, of course, he's going to be allowed to contest.
Well, we don't know that for sure.
We don't
know that for sure.
Well, he's going to be allowed to contest. It was part of those that were shortlisted for vying for the FIFA presidency.
All right.
So, but the team...
Well, FIFA released the final shortlist. Well, now, remember, the question now, there might be a lot of legal loopholes.
Yes,
that maybe
to be exploited.
Okay. Because you cleared your name and you were...
That is what I'm saying.
You might be given a special dispensation in order to contest. So, there's still so much that can go on.
A very long
time. Time is against him.
He's definitely run out of time.
I think we all agree on that. Time is against him. All right, let's talk about CONCACAF. Interesting. Tunde, I can see you laughing already.
When you talk of CONCACAF, you can only talk of one man.
Yes.
That's Jack Warner.
Yeah.
And his former sidekick, Chuck Blazer.
Yes.
So,
this is a sidekick.
Those guys are not in a hurry. Actually. Those guys are not in a hurry to choose a new president. And that's really the story. Ideally, one of the most senior vice presidents should be promoted into that position, but in recent times, the last 3-4 years, you have three of their former president either indicted, removed, facing one charges, and those guys are like, okay, we've had enough.
The truth about it, like I said before, CONCACAF and CONMEBOL are within the United States of America's sphere of influence.
Yes,
and you know, they are currently scrutinizing anybody and anything and everything that has to do with football and irregular payments. So it's a poison chalice. Nobody wants it right now. This man Jack Warner, who has bestrode the CONCACAF politics and FIFA politics like a colossus for many years. The fact that he was brought crashing down so ignominiously has left a lot of people in shock and in awe that, look, if Jack Warner can get something like this, who are we? So those who still have a few bones, not even skeletons in their cupboards, are reluctant
to come forward.
Jeffrey Webb, who was a lot of people thought was
an American,
who was thought to also be a strong contender for the FIFA presidency, was also ignominiously arrested and bundled off like a common criminal. And Chuck Blazer as well, who is the American, a man who was also indicted for almost 10 or 15 counts of wire fraud, which the Americans take very seriously. This man, Jeffrey Webb, Chuck Blazer, did he bought condominiums and stuffed them with cash.
Okay.
Raw cash. And the Americans don't take lightly to that. So it's a poison chalice right now. Nobody wants to take up the challenge because they know that whoever comes forward,
scrutinized,
whether you like it or not,
they're going to be facing the heat.
The FBI are already even investigating you.
They know
looking
you before
for
you
debt,
step out.
Of course. So it's going to be difficult.
We just saw Jack Warner, and Tony talked about him. He said the United States is winning the war to... They are the football police of the world.
To take over FIFA.
Yeah. Okay, let me quickly allow you react to that. Are they football police? Do they have an agenda, or you think that what they're doing is good for the game?
Well, I wouldn't know. Honestly, I wouldn't know because for me, in the first place, I do not understand why the FBI or the United States are coming in to clear things in FIFA.
Let me
in
tell you why.
Okay, why?
The vast majority of the monies that below the
pass through their system,
pass through the American financial system.
Okay, for me, I feel is way beyond their jurisdiction. Anyway, I do not know. Like I said, I wouldn't know.
Anything that passes through the American system.
Like I said, I wouldn't know. But then, football police, I'm not sure.
Is it a just cause? Let me just allow you.
Is it a just cause?
Is it a just cause?
I'm going to sit on the fence and just say that FIFA needs to be cleansed. Now, I don't know if it's a just cause.
Somebody has to do the job.
Wait, some people will tell you that probably the United States have a hidden agenda.
Because they lost out in the 2026.
The truth is, let's look at this conspiracy theory. If America got the 2022 World Cup.
We probably will not hear this.
I agree.
Would they have been doing this?
They will still be doing
If England had gotten the 2018 World Cup, would there have been any rank calls?
I agree. So, England wouldn't have said anything.
Sorry, that's a $1 billion question. So okay. They should answer it by themselves.
Okay. That's interesting. And we'll leave it at that. It gets interesting by the day. We'll see what happens in FIFA. A lot of things happening right now. January, February, as events lead up to that election, a lot of things will come on. And the Americans have said, look, just be ready. Anybody can be consumed. So we'll see what will happen in the days to come. But let's see if we can give you some quick update around the UEFA Champions League. Well, some goals have been scored. Real Madrid have put 2 goals past Malmo. It's 2-0 as we speak. Wolfsburg and Manchester United, 1 goal apiece. And of course, Manchester City and Borussia Mönchengladbach is 1 goal apiece. So in the other games, no goals scored yet. But in those 3 matches that we just talked about, goals have been scored. Well, Cosmos, I won't allow you leave without